Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to interface a HC-05 Bluetooth module with an Arduino Uno, and we will control the module using a computer. Now in my previous video, we controlled the module using an app on a smartphone. If you're not quite familiar with how the Bluetooth module works, its features, its functions, do check out my previous video by clicking the link up here. If you guys like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up by clicking that like button. And if you haven't done so already, go ahead and click that subscribe button right now. Without waiting any longer, let's get into it. I'm Chums, and welcome to That's Engineering. Alright, so before we actually get into building the circuit, let's have a quick look at the order of operations. So first of all, the command will be entered into the Arduino IDE or Integrated Development Environment using the serial monitor. This command will then be sent to the HC-05 module via Bluetooth on the relevant COM or communication port. The Bluetooth module will then send the command to the Arduino, and the Arduino will try to match that command to any pre-written or pre-existing commands and will then execute that command as such. Now let's have a quick look at the list of components followed by the circuit diagram. So these are a list of components that you would need. Apart from the obvious, you would need a couple of LEDs, a 2 kilo ohm and a 1 kilo ohm resistor. Now let's have a look at the circuit diagram. So this circuit diagram is the exact same circuit that we were using in the previous video. There have been no changes, but if you haven't watched the previous video, I'll go through this circuit diagram again. So first of all, I have two LEDs here, and they're both connected through two resistors to port 8 and 7, which are arbitrarily chosen. You can choose any two ports. 5 volts and ground are connected to VCC and ground respectively. Enable and state have been left blank as they're not really needed. The two main ports would be RX and TX, which are the receiving and transmitting ports. Now TX has been connected directly to port 2, while RX is connected through a voltage divider to port number 3. So RX actually requires 3.3 volts to operate. The HC-05 module has an inbuilt voltage regulator, so you can actually directly connect port 3 to the RX of the HC-05 and supply 5 volts, and the inbuilt regulator would regulate that voltage to 3.3 volts. But to be on the safe side and to prevent any damage to the components, we would be using this resistor configuration to make a voltage divider which would produce 3.3 volts on the output over here when 5 volts are supplied to port 3. So something to note is that if you have your HC-05 module along with your Arduino, the receiving port or the RX port on the module would correspond to the transmitting port on the Arduino, and the transmitting port here would be the receiving port here. And this makes sense because if you look at it, when the module receives something, it has to be transmitted by the Arduino, and if the module transmits something, it would be received by the Arduino. Now let's go through the code that I wrote for the Arduino. So this is the Arduino code that I wrote for this particular circuit to control the Bluetooth module using a computer. Now this code is quite similar to my previous code in the previous video where we used the smartphone to control the Bluetooth module. The only differences are in the loop section, but I will go through the code step by step all over again. I have a copy of the code in a link in the comment section down below, so feel free to check it out or use it in any of your projects. So I started off by including this library, softwareserial.h, and I did that because I specified the TX and RX ports of the Bluetooth module as port 2 and 3 on the Arduino. I could have used ports 0 and 1, which are the dedicated ports for serial communication. But if I did that, every time I wanted to or needed to upload a code to the Arduino, I would have to unplug those wires, as port 0 and 1 are used when uploading a code to the Arduino. Because of this, we need to specify port 2 and 3 as virtual serial ports. So that's what's done using the software serial Bluetooth command, where TX and RX have been specified to create a virtual serial port. Instead of using a string, this time I used a character for the variable value. So this variable is what stores the data sent from the Bluetooth module. Moving on to setup, the LEDs were kept as an output, and I started communication with the Bluetooth module at its default baud rate of 9600. Within loop, if Bluetooth is available, so that means if data is being received from the Bluetooth module, we will read the data using this function and store it in this variable value. You can then use any if statement to have your pre-written or your pre-existing commands. So for example, if the value is equal to 1, turn the blue LED on by using a digital write to set the blue LED to high, and print this statement blue LED on the console. Similarly, if value equals 2, you turn the blue LED off, and similar for the red LED. Now let's have a look at a demo based on the circuit I built. Right, so the first step would actually be to pair your computer with the Bluetooth module. Now to do this, go to Bluetooth settings, turn on Bluetooth, and add the Bluetooth or other device, given that your Bluetooth module is already plugged in and working. You find HC-05, click it, and when asked for a password, you give 1, 2, 3, 4, and press connect. Once this is done, click done and head back to your Arduino IDE. You now need to find the communication port used for your computer to communicate to the Bluetooth module. To do this, go to control panel, select hardware and sound, or view devices and printers, and find HC-05. Right click it and select properties, and under hardware it would show you the communication port over here. So you can see it uses a standard serial over Bluetooth link COM4. So in my case, my computer uses communication port 4 to talk to the Bluetooth module. Your computer might have a different communication port. Just keep this in mind. Head over to services, and make sure this box is ticked. If so, press OK. Now head back to your Arduino IDE. Once the Arduino code has been uploaded onto your Arduino device, go to Tools, Port, and select the port that is used for your computer to connect or to communicate to the Bluetooth module. In my case, it's COM4, it's already selected, and open up the serial monitor. So this is where you will type in the commands. For this code, the commands would be the contents of the variable value, which would be 1, 2, 3, or 4. So you can just type it in, press enter, and the code would run. Alright guys, so this is the circuit that we built. It's the exact same circuit as in the previous video. There have been no changes. So I've actually already paired my computer with the Bluetooth module, as I explained previously, going to Device Manager and doing all those settings. But the light still keeps blinking on the Bluetooth module until you open the serial monitor on the computer. So it hasn't fully paired until the serial monitor is opened up. So I'm going to zoom in to my computer screen. Right. So I'm going to go to Tools, Port, and change the port first to COM3, which is the port the computer uses to talk to the Arduino via the USB cable. And then I'm going to re-upload the code. Right. I'll go back to Tools, switch the port to COM4, so the computer can talk to the Bluetooth module via Bluetooth and open the serial monitor.
And once the serial monitor is open, let me zoom out a little. So now you can see that the LED on the Bluetooth module blinks at a lower frequency to show that it has been successfully paired with the computer. So you just head over to the console on the serial monitor, press 1 and enter, and the blue LED turns on. 2 to off it, 3 for the red LED, and 4 turn that off. You can then on both LEDs by pressing 1, then 3, and off them by pressing 2, then 4.
Alright guys, so that's all for this video. If you guys like the video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up by clicking the like button below. If you have any questions or clarifications on the work we just did, feel free to leave a comment and I will do my best to get back to you. I hope this video helped, and if you haven't done so already, go ahead and click that subscribe button right now. And I'll see you all in the next video. Thanks for watching.